be wonders like this. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. I thank God for tonight because he has given me an opportunity to come and share a message I love. Praise be to God. Because tonight I came with an apostolic anointing and I joined with the prophetic in the house and I come to declare I am cutting every cord of the enemy in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. Every cord that I make you to be stagnant, tonight is the night to cut it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise be to Jesus. Somebody say, I will cut it. I want to go with the, whoever is putting this on, put one. Let's use this. Amen. Yeah. Okay. The Bible says, again, the word of the Lord came to me. Praise be to Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah, amen. Children of God. Tonight, I am happy. We are getting a message from a prophet who have heard God before. It is not the first time that he is hearing God. So this is not guesswork. Tell your neighbor, it is not guesswork. It's not even a trial. The man of God, Ezekiel, he is speaking and he is saying, again, the word of God comes to me. Praise be to God. And the word of God came with a message. When the word of God comes, it comes with a purpose. When the word of God comes, it comes more than you can do. The word of God is coming to somebody tonight. And I come to tell you, child of God, if you let it come in your life, it will not go back to his voice. It will accomplish that what it's supposed to do. Somebody lift your hand and say, Father, let not your word go back to you void. Praise be to Jesus. This word will work on your life. Whether you say amen or not, whether you sleep on me or not, this word will work on your life. Praise be to Jesus. Tell your neighbor it will work. Tell another neighbor it will work. Maybe you had it another time and never worked. But tonight I come to promise you, it will work in your life. It will work in your life. It will work in your life. Somebody lift your hand and say, Father, let the word work. Again, the word of the Lord came unto me. Praise be to Jesus. And the word was saying, Son of man, cause Jerusalem to know her abomination. Amen. Let's continue. And say, thus says the Lord God unto Jerusalem, thy birth and the nativity is the land of Canaan. Praise be to Jesus. Thy father was an Amorite and thy mother a Hittite. Praise be to Jesus. I have heard people say, there is no worry about Kihumbo kiria nyumete, kutiri vena na kuria nyumete, no dokago kwira atiriri. There is a problem today. Hallelujah. We got to deal with some foundation issues. We got to deal with some things that have been chasing us for many years. We got to deal with some foundation issues. Tell your neighbor, foundation issues. Hallelujah. We want to deal with some foundation issues. And the Bible says, cause Jerusalem to know her abomination. And listen to me, Jerusalem. Jerusalem, I'm speaking to you. Thy birth and thy nativity is in the land of Canaan. Hallelujah. Praise be to Jesus. Praise be to God. But there is a problem here. Your father was an Amorite. Hallelujah. We know where you were born, understand? We know your nativity, understand? But listen, your story is different. Your mother was an Amorite. So all the spirit of Amorites, they claim you. Praise be to Jesus. The Amorites, they are spirit, they are powers, they claim you. They say you are an Amorite. And your father was an Amorite, and thy mother a Hittite. Praise be to Jesus. Tell your neighbor, what a foundation. Bwana asifiwe sana. Nikoe washialiwa America. Nova boa nyume tena guko akaku. Na mabua nyuna kiume tena guko. Na gatagati kau, let us know what happened. That is not an issue anyway. But let's see where the issue is, number four. And for thy nativity, in the day thou was born, the navel was not cut. Praise be to God. Your mother was a Hittite, and your father was an Amorite. But even if you're born in the land of Canaan, there is something that never happened. You were never called, was not cut. So that simply means you still have the genealogy of the Hittite, the Amorite, and you have the Canaanite in you. So in your life, there is a kind of confusion, something that is not going on well. There is a work that needed to be done, but it was not done the way you were the day you were born. Today I come to declare in the name of Jesus Christ, there is an anointing in this house that will cut that cord, that cord that has been holding you, that cord of generation. Tonight in the name of Jesus, somebody say, cut it! There are those who miss it, there are those who get it. But I come to tell you, after we cut that cord, there are things you never used to be able to do. You are going to do them in Jesus' name. There are places you never used to go. You will be able to go in the name of Jesus. There are levels you never used to go. You will go because the love of God is cut. Today in Jesus' name, I cut it in the name of Jesus. I preached a message last time and I said somewhere, I shall not be like my father. I shall not be like my father. The mistakes my father made, I shall not make them. The tears my mother cried, I shall not cry them. Because tonight I come to cut the cord. Somebody shout, I shall not be like my father. I know you can say louder than that, I shall not be like my father. Loud, I love, I don't know. I need something to give me a backup. Is it this? Praise be. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, I shall not be like my father. That mistake your father made, you are not going to make it in the name of Jesus. Those tears your mother used to cry, you shall not cry them in the name of Jesus. I come to cut the cord. You shall be greater than your father. You shall do greater than your father. In the name of Jesus Christ, you shall go to places where your father never went. I refuse to be like my father. I am not going to be like my father. I shall not die poor like my father. I shall not be in tears. I refuse to be like my father. Mom, I love you. Mom, I know the work you did. Mom, I know the suffering you went to bring me up. But listen to me, Mom. For me to be a better person, I refuse to be like you. I refuse to be like you. I love you, my mama. I care about you. But I cut my cord. I shall not be like my father. Praise be to Jesus. Are you listening to me, somebody? Oh, my God. You are never cut, was not cut. That is why the same struggles that your older brother is struggling, are the same struggle you are struggling with. The same forces that chased your uncle, are the same forces that are chasing you. This is why, child of God, the same sickness in the family that has killed your mother, that killed your uncle, they are the same sicknesses that are chasing you. But tonight I come by the power and the anointing of the Holy Ghost to cut the cord, to cut the cord. Somebody say, cut it! It's up to you if you don't want to cut it. But I promise you, you can never go out the same person, because we'll cut the cord. We will cut it in the name of Jesus. Praise be to Jesus. I refuse the cycles, demonic cycles in the family. I come to declare, you shall not go through the same cycle. I come to declare, you shall not go through the same cycle. bothers your cousins, all those who are named Wajiko like you. They shall not bother you, because I am cutting the cord. I am cutting the cord. Somebody say, cut it! Tonight is a deliverance night.